Jeroboam was king of Israel, not Judah, but the northern part of the country, Israel. And he was not a good king. He built, we've talked about that, he built idols for the people to worship so they wouldn't go back to Jerusalem and Judah to worship the true God. He wanted them to stay in his country. He was afraid they wouldn't stay his subjects if they went to the other kingdom for worship service to worship the true God. And he just generally all around was not a very good king. At one point, one of his sons got sick. And the Bible makes it sound like it was a small child, but we really don't know how old the son was. So they didn't know what to do. Finally, Jeroboam told his wife, "There is a prophet of the true God near here, but he's not going to talk to us because we're not worshiping the true God. So you disguise yourself as someone else, and you go and ask him what we need to do for our son." So she dressed up as someone else, pretended to not be the king's wife, and she went to see the prophet, but before she even got in the door, the prophet said, "Come in, Jeroboam's wife." Actually, she needn't have even dressed up. This prophet was blind. He was old and had lost his eyesight, so he couldn't have seen how she was disguised anyway. But God told them before she ever got there, "Look, Jeroboam's wife is coming, and she's pretending to be someone else, but it's Jeroboam's wife." So when she got there, he said, "Come on in." He said, "God's not real happy with you and your husband and your kingdom right now. And yeah, your son is sick, and your son is going to die. As soon as you get back home, he will die. But he's going to die because this son of yours loves the true God. And God wants to spare him what's fixing to happen to your family. So the whole country is going to mourn this son, and he's going to be buried with honors. But nobody else in your family will be. The rest of you are going to die, and you're going to die violently. And the dogs are going to eat you if you die in the city, and the vultures are going to eat you if you die in the country. You're not going to be honored because you have rejected the true God. Our sins, our disobedience to God has consequences. But our obedience to God brings blessings. Had Jeroboam chosen to worship the true God, God would have blessed him. God would have made him a lasting kingdom. But he didn't. He chose to disobey, and that brought consequences. The consequence that his family would be wiped out. That this would be the last righteous person in his family. And the Bible doesn't say exactly what her reaction was to this news.
As soon as she gets home.
Well, I kind of think I would have sent a message to my husband, said, "I'm never coming home. No offense, not personal. I'm just not coming home." But she went home, and as soon as she stepped in the house, her son died. Exactly what God had said was going to happen. And Jeroboam's family will be punished for their disobedience. So, let's sing a song.
God made me.
Thank you.